We sold it from 160 to 200 or something like that.
A nice, tidy profit.
Yeah, we made about $3.5 billion on a $500 million investment, as it turned out. I still sold it way too soon. Since I sold it, they must have shot a gun off and said, Warren sold. Now it's time to let it go up.
Well, yeah, you left money on the table.
A lot of money.
Dummy.
That's exactly right.
Charlie Munger would say.
Charlie would say, you've done it again.
But you can't keep always trying. For the average person who's maybe never bought a stock before, what's your advice about that? You can't constantly sit there and wait and say, oh, it's going to go higher, it's going to go higher.
We don't even think about that. What we think about is, how much is it selling for? How much do we think it's worth? When we bought it at $35 billion, effectively, I felt the company was probably worth at least $100 billion.
How did it come to your attention? How do you find a stock like PetroChina?
I sit there in my office and I read an annual report, which fortunately was in English, and it described a very good company. And told about the oil reserves, told about the refining, told about the chemicals, everything else. And I sat there and read it, and I thought to myself, this company is worth about $100 billion. Now, I didn't look at the price first. I look at the business first and try and figure out what it's worth, because if I look at the price first, I'll get influenced by that. So I look at the company first. I try to value it, and then I look at the price, and if the price is way less than what I've just valued it at, I'm going to buy it.
And how do you value it?
Well, that's the trick. Yeah. But it's essentially what I would pay for the whole business if I could buy it. And when we sold the company stock, it was valued, we'll say, at probably $250 to $275 billion. And we thought that was a fair price. Now, oil had gone up from $30 a barrel to $75 a barrel. Now it's up even further. But today, yesterday anyway, I believe PetroChina is the second most highly valued company in the world.
Second
higher
to
than
what?
GE, next to Exxon.
ExxonMobil.
Next to Exxon.
Have you sold the entire stake?
Yeah, I have.
As
I wish I hadn't, but I have.
As of when?
Well, we sold it over a period of time.
Sold it over
months,
a period of time.
If it went down a lot, we'd buy it back.
Would you ever buy or sell a stock based on political pressure people being upset about Darfur had nothing to do with why you sold this stock?
The Chinese government owns 88% of PetroChina. They also own control of 29 out of the 30 largest companies in China. The Chinese government is the one that has a position in relation to the Sudan. And they have it. If you own any one of the 30 largest companies in publicly traded companies in China, you will have the Chinese government as your majority partner. And the question is, are you responsible for their actions?
You're going to China next week for a ribbon-cutting ceremony for ISCAR.
Limit of my abilities, Liz. I mean, that's what they use this.
You're pretty good at cutting a ribbon.
I've gotten used to it, yeah.
Are you looking at other companies in China?
No, the answer is pretty much no. But I don't look based on countries or that sort of thing. I just read every report I can, and I try and figure out whether something is cheap.
But how would you find a report like PetroChina 4 years ago? This was not a name that maybe that a lot of people would...
Other guys read Playboy. Yeah. I read annual reports.
Legend of the Phoenix.